This poem was written during the years of the Depression and has the young boy going out to look for a job which may never be found, and the sister trying to help in a way which may never be helpful. It did not begin with the two people for me. It began with the arrow, with the neon arrow, rushing down the wall of a building and turning a corner to hit its mark, always to hit its mark. It's called Boy with His Hair Cut Short. Sunday shuts down on this 20th century evening. The L passes. Twilight and bulb define the brown room, the overstuffed plum sofa, the boy, and the girl's thin hands above his head. A neighbor radio sings stocks, news, serenade. He sits at the table, head down, the young clear neck exposed, watching the drugstore sign from the tail of his eye. Tattoo neon until the eye blears, while his solicitous tall sister, simple in blue, bending behind him, cuts his hair with her cheap shears. The arrow's electric red always reaches its mark. Successful neon. He coughs, impressed by that precision. His child's forehead, forever protected by his cap, is bleached against the lamplight as he turns head and steadies to let the snippets drop, erasing the failure of weeks with level fingers. She sleeks the fine hair, combing. You'll look fine tomorrow. You'll surely find something. They can't keep turning you down. The finest gentleman's not so trim as you. Smiling, he raises the adolescent forehead, wrinkling, ironic now. He sees his decent suit laid out, new pressed, his carfare on the shelf. He lets his head fall, meeting her earnest, hopeless look, seeing the sharp blades splitting the darkened room, the impersonal sign, her motion, the blue vein bright on her temple, pitifully beating.